As per officials, the DRDO has begun a thorough investigation of an accident involving an indigenously developed howitzer in Pokhran, Rajasthan last week. The accident took place when the howitzer was undergoing firing. The advanced towed artillery gun system is being developed by the DRDO along with two private players. Scientists are probing the detail into the accident. DRDO chairman Dr. G. Satish Reddy told PTI, the army require a sizable number of ATGS for deployment along the frontiers with China and Pakistan. In 2017, the army received the first batch of two ultralight howitzer from the US after 30 years wait for new artillery gun since the induction of Bofors gun in 1980s. The M777A2 ultralight howitzer have a maximum range of 30 km and it is manufactured by BE Systems. On Genoa snooping issue, Chinese spokesperson told media, "I want to stress that Genoa is a private company and has no link to the Chinese government. There are many foreign companies engaged in such similar business." He added, "Relevant report make groundless accusation on presumption of guilt, purposely trying to find excuse aiming to blame others." Whereas the Ministry of External Affairs said that an expert committee under the National Cyber Security Coordinator has been constituted to study report of surveillance of Indian by Chinese firm, evaluating its implication and assess any violation of law. The expert team will submit its recommendation within 30 days, External Affairs Ministry spokesperson Anurag Srivastava said at the regular media briefing that the ministry has taken up the matter of surveillance with the Chinese side. As per army officials, a Pulwama-style terror attack was aborted on Thursday by the Indian Army with the recovery of 52 kg of explosive in Kashmir. The location where the explosives were recovered was near to a national highway and close to the site of last year's Pulwama terror attack that had killed 40 CRPF personnel, they said. "We have aborted another Pulwama-type attack," said an army official. According to the officials, an explosive was found in the water tank during a search operation around 8 a.m. There were 416 packets of explosive, with each of them weighing 125 grams, said an official. He said another 50 detonators were recovered in another tank in the area of subsequent search. The explosives are called Super 90 or S90 in short, they said. The Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade issued a press note permitting foreign direct investment in defense production above 74% on the automatic route. This would be a subject to access some modern technology or for other reasons that need to be recorded. FDI in defense production is automatic up to 74%, the department said. Till now, 100% foreign investment were permitted in the defense industry, 49% under automatic route, and government approval was required beyond that. The press note has stipulated that foreign investment in the defense sector would be subject to scrutiny on the ground of national security, and the government reserves the right to review any foreign investment in the sector that affect or may be affect national security. As per press note 4/2020 series, FDI up to 74% under automatic route shall be permitted for companies seeking new industry license. DPIIT also said that infusion of fresh investment up to 49% in a company not seeking industrial license or which already has government approval for FDI in defense shall require mandatory submission of a declaration with the Defense Ministry in case change in equity or shareholding pattern or transfer of stakes by existing investor to a new foreign investor for FDI up to 49% within 30 days of such changes. Proposal for rising FDI beyond 49% for such company will require government approval, it added.
Thanks for watching. I hope you like this news. Please share your views in comment box. Please like and share this video. Press subscribe button and bell for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, Warn.